Look, people have tried to downplay the extent of Hamas's horrors that they inflicted. Some people turn Hamas into freedom fighters. But in fact, the barbarities from October 7 and since shows that Hamas are on par or worse than ISIS, on par or worse than the Nazis.
I agree. I'm a descendant of my grandmother was in Auschwitz, and I've seen ashes in Auschwitz where my grandmother was, and I had to put ashes in a coffin. It feels like, you know, the world is going, you know, we're in the Western world, we're going forward. Christian, Muslims, Jewish people, the world is going ahead, and the Hamas and Hezbollah, they just, you know, trying to pull us back. You know, facing it make me proud. Make me proud to be Jewish. Make me proud to say I'm adding good to the world. I'm trying to be good. I'm trying to fight the bad. I'm taking. I want to say to everyone, you know, take the right path. There's things that I even can't talk about what I've seen, but listen to the truth. Listen to the good and think which part you want to take. Who do you want to join?
And that's why you're in Australia at the moment. I mean, I can't even imagine how that would have affected you emotionally, seeing what you witnessed on October 7.
It is affecting, but it's mostly I'm looking ahead. Many people lost their lives, and family are obviously devastated. And we are looking forward for the world, for the Jewish people, for all the people, just to continue with the good. And this is why I'm here. People said, aren't you scared to leave your country? I'm not scared of Hamas. I'm not scared of Hezbollah. I just want to say to the world, we shouldn't be scared of them. We should just don't let them continue and stop them and let people fight against them.
All right. Noah Lewis, well, I can't even say thank you very much for being here, but I find your courage extraordinary, and I can't imagine doing the job that you do on a daily basis, even, you know, apart from October 7th. So thank you so much.
Thank you.